idea the kingdom starts with a form of teaching. See? That eventually will manifest into a physical kingdom. But it starts with this doctrine. That's the kingdom. And unless you're born again, you will not be able to see or enter into that kingdom or that form of teaching. See? So when you go back here again to the book of St. John, the third chapter, and again, the third verse, Yahweh shall answer and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see, or understand the kingdom of the Most High. So what's the Lord expressing here is there has to be a transition made. That's what it means to be born again. You can no longer walk in the flesh. You have to walk in the spirit to entertain this form of teaching to see the kingdom. See, verse 4, Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Yahweh shall answer, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of the Most High. And again, this kingdom of the Most High right here is symbolic to this truth, man. Because you're going to have Jakes who will not be born of the Spirit on this side in this lifetime, yet they will enter into the kingdom physically, you know, in the world to come. So what does it mean when the scriptures say, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except the man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of the Most High? That's concerning this truth, man, this realm, all right, this council. You have to be born again. There has to be a transition in your mind. You have to view things through spiritual lenses to enter into this dwelling place, man, to enter into the courts of Yahweh Bashem Yahusha, to enter into the kingdom, which again starts with a teaching. See that? Verse 6, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. See? Marvel not that I say unto thee, ye must be born again. Now, real quick, let's look up this word born.
Strong's G 1080, Genao.
Yeah, and that's the pronunciation in the Greek. And it says, of men who father children to be born, to be begotten of women giving birth to children. Yeah, so this is the obvious definition when you go into that word born, you know, especially at face value. But when you go to the metaphor for this word born, which our Lord Yahweh was speaking to Nicodemus metaphorically, it says to engender. Now that word engender translates to being brought about. Alright, to engender, cause to arise, excite, in a Jewish sense of one who brings others over to his way of life. Let's read this again. In a Jewish sense of one who brings others over to his way of life, to convert someone. See that? So to be born again means to be converted from a carnal outlook to viewing things through spiritual lenses. And guess what? You will never be able to come into the full understanding to grasp what the Bible is talking about unless you are born again, unless you are converted, unless there's a transition in your mind. And that's outlined right here in the book of Romans, the 12th chapter in the 2nd verse. It says, and be not conformed to this world, meaning you must reject, you know, omit anything that the so-called white man has packaged and attempted to present unto you. You are not to receive that spirit. You are not to be acclimated to this world. That's the only way you will be able to come into this arena. The only way the Lord is going to accept you, you must become separate. Matter of fact, let's prove that before we continue this, the book of 2 Corinthians, the 6th chapter. In the 17th verse, it says, wherefore, come out from among them. See, and how do you accomplish that feat? through the mind, mentally, you must depart from this place. See? Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate. See? And be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. So in order for the Lord to receive you, in order for you to partake in his hearing, you must not touch the unclean thing, which goes back to Esau, the so-called white man, and whatever he's trying to present to you, man, in the form of, you know, his rhetoric, whatever ideas and philosophies that's on display here in America, from whatever platform, whether it's his media, his legislations, down to his trends, you know, the institutions and universities that's on display that push forth the madness of the so-called white man, you are not to cleave unto that, but separate from it. Then the Lord will receive you, see? And how is that accomplished? Again, through the mind. See that? So when you go back here again to the book of Romans, the 12th chapter, and again the 2nd verse, it says, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing or rebirth, by the renewing of your mind. So this is what it means to be born again, to be born of the Spirit. See? Let's read this again. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. See? That ye may prove what is that good, that acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh Bashim HaWashah. So in order for you to understand the will of the Heavenly Father through his Son, you must be born again. That's why you see so many people struggle with the idea of the Lord destroying America, you know, destroying men, women, and children, and only delivering his elect. Well, the reason why you're not able to understand that perfect will of Yahweh Bashim HaWashah, his intents, purposes, and plans, is because you haven't been born again. You haven't made that transition. See? From this carnal walk to viewing things through spiritual lenses. See that? And again, this is what separates the believers from the masses of the people out there. We have developed another outlook. We actually dwell in a whole nother realm. And again, the entry point to that realm is the mind. See? So in order for you to come into this hearing and even entertain this form of teaching, one must renew his mind. One must be born again. Pretty much you have to view things through spiritual lenses. So yeah, I just want to touch on that, Lord willing. It was edifying. Till the next time I say shalom.